Hello heroes! If you are experiencing system freezes, lags or delays while using Photoshop, I'll show you 10 tricks to help you work quickly and efficiently. After that, your Adobe Photoshop performance will be as a rocket. Let's start! Adjust memory usage. You can improve performance by increasing the amount of memory allocated to Photoshop. To change the amount of allocated memory, go to Edit, Preferences, Performance. By default, Photoshop uses 70% of available RAM. Changing memory usage has a positive effect on Photoshop performance. As you see, I have 16GB RAM. So it's more than enough to edit photos via Photoshop. For 32-bit version, the usage of 100% of the available memory can cause problems. If possible, you should use 64-bit Photoshop version, which allows allocating up to 100% of memory for your work. In my opinion, 85% seems to be a best choice. Add RAM. Photoshop uses random access memory to process images. If Photoshop has insufficient memory, it uses hard disk space, also known as a scratch disk. Accessing information in memory is faster than accessing information on a hard disk. Therefore, Photoshop is fastest when it can process image information in RAM. 8GB RAM is recommended to use for the latest version of Photoshop at least. I prefer using 16GB RAM. You will find a link on a RAM that I am using in video description. There is another way. A lot of open documents in Photoshop CC slows down the work intentionally and can lead to the lack of memory notification. So you can close them as fast as you finish work with them. Adjust the cache. Increasing cache levels improves Photoshop responsiveness while you work. To change these settings, go to Edit, Preferences, Performance. 3 cache presets are available in the Performance Preferences. Choose the one that matches your primary purpose of using Photoshop. Choose Web UI Design if you use Photoshop primarily for web, app or screen design. Choose Default Photos if you use Photoshop primarily to retouch or edit moderate size images. Use this option if you normally edit photos originating from your mobile or digital camera. Choose Huge pixel dimensions if you work extensively with heavy documents in Photoshop. You can save scratch disk space and improve performance by limiting or reducing the number of history states. Photoshop can save up to 1000 history states. Accordingly, the less data you will be storing in history, the less place Photoshop will take. If you always work with a copy of your layer, it's enough to leave 20 last actions in history. Add scratch disks. If your disk has multiple drives, then you can add those as scratch disks to allow Photoshop for using your disk as a memory for better performance. In fact, using a solid-state disk is probably better than using a separate hard disk as your primary scratch disk. A solid-state disk performs well as both the primary startup and scratch disk. If your startup disk is a hard disk, try using a different hard disk for your primary scratch disk. Adjust background options. The Save in Background preference is enabled by default. When it's on, Photoshop lets you continue working while Save and Save As commands are performed, instead of requiring you to wait until they complete. Usually, background save operations don't significantly affect the performance or responsiveness of normal Photoshop operations. However, if you are editing a file that is much larger than available RAM, the Save operation can affect responsiveness or performance until the save is complete. If you notice performance issues, decrease the frequency of the automatically save recovery information preference. Pay attention, setting a lower value for the recovery interval gives you more protection against crashes. GPU setting. If a suitable video card is installed on your system, it will appear in the GPU settings area of the performance section. I'm using GeForce GTX 1060. It's great for video editing as well as for photo editing. You will find a link on it in video description. Click Advanced Setting. Select Basic, Normal or Advanced, matching the option with your requirements. Basic. It uses the least amount of GPU memory to run the most basic OpenGL. Normal is the default setting. It uses a large amount of GPU memory to support advanced OpenGL features and should be selected if you regularly use the GPU accelerated features in Photoshop. Advanced uses the same amount of memory as the normal mode, but enables more advanced features to improve drawing performance. This setting is the best when working in 3D or when working extensively with the GPU accelerated features. Export the clipboard. The export clipboard option causes Photoshop to make the contents of the clipboard available to other programs. If you are not using any copied data other than in Photoshop, then it's best to uncheck this option. The option is located in the Preferences under General. Purge data. If it starts lagging, what to do in this situation? You can improve system performance by freeing up unused memory and scratch this space from Photoshop. To reset the data, go to Edit, Purge and choose Clipboard, History or Roll. As a result, the data related to Clipboard, History or Roll at the same time will be reset. Pay attention, this command can be cancelled. Drag files. Dragging layers or files is more efficient than copying and pasting them. Dragging bypasses the clipboard and transfers data directly. Copying and pasting can potentially involve more data transfer and is much less efficient. Use shortcuts. Keyboard combinations help to work a little faster. I showed 11 best keyboard shortcuts in my previous video. You will find a link in video description. I hope these tips will help you to optimize your Photoshop CC performance. Pay attention to restart Photoshop to enable your changes. Which other way of optimizing performance do you use? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section below. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe How to GoPro for more great videos just like this one. See you soon!